In the few minutes I have left with you, Chris, I want the evaluation for two more teams. Let's start with Atlanta. What a big decision they've got at four after the three quarterbacks go off the board. Do they take one of the two remaining ones, start the clock on Matt Ryan's departure on the spot? Julio Jones apparently could be a cap trade casualty. They might try to figure out how to get him signed. Or do you go Kyle Pitts? What do you do if you're Atlanta? Chris, what do you think?
I'm going to tell you what – I can only tell you what I would do. I mean, Atlanta's in cap hell right now. I mean, they really are. They've got to dump some salary and start rebuilding this thing. I would put a sign out if I were the Atlanta Falcons and the Cincinnati Bengals at 4-5, and I would say, I am not keeping this pick. Whoever offers me the most for one of these quarterbacks, I am definitely making that trade, because I don't want people thinking you can end up trading with Miami or Detroit at 6 or 7, and you're going to be able to get one of these quarterbacks. No, you want one. I'm definitely trading out to somebody who wants a quarterback. And if I were the Bengals sitting right behind them, I would do the exact same thing and see if I couldn't, because I think that then you would end up with the entire draft behind you and some solid players. There are some solid. I happen to think that Pitts and Jamar Chase are even above solid with very little risk to them. But I would want to trade down, because I think the rest of the first round, after the first 7 or 8 players, are all okay, are all good players. But I don't find myself at the end of this draft going like I usually do. Like, oh, my God, I've left 10 first-round draft picks out of the first round when I did my mock draft. I find myself in picks 20 through 32 going, now, who can I put in the first round, and who do I really believe in without much doubt and without injury factors and all? So I wouldn't even mind trading back into next year, because I just have a feeling that this will be remembered, other than the quarterbacks and 2 or 3 handful of players, as being a good, not a great draft.
Because that was my last one, was the Bengals. You know, we had Carson Palmer on last week. He said, take Penny Sewell and don't even look in the direction of Chase. Let's just say that they don't trade out, that people don't knock on their door for that other quarterback, and that the Bengals have the choice of protecting Joe Burrow or getting him a weapon with whom he's quite familiar in Chase. What would you do?
I know what Joe Burrow would do. I talked to Joe on my podcast not too long ago, and not that he came out and said that he wanted Jamar Chase, but you could tell they were like buddies. You know, they were like friends. They were magical together at LSU. And then Chase turned around and ran that 4.37. I said, did that surprise you? He goes, yeah. I knew he was a great player. And he could do phenomenal things at the catch point. I didn't know he could run like that. And Penei Sewell is going to be that good too. But I would take any of these top 3 tackles and feel pretty good about getting a tackle. So if I had to slide myself back down, you know, 3, 4, 5 slots, if I were the Bengals, I would feel pretty darn good about that tackle position, if that's where I wanted to go.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.